Hello and welcome to DrummerConnection.com. Today's drum lesson is 16th note triplet fills, part one. We're going to look into this concept of playing a steady flow of 16th note triplets around the drums, broken between the hands and the feet. 16th note triplets are also called sextuplets, meaning that there are six beats for every quarter note. We're going to start the concept today with playing four notes on the snare and two on the bass drum. We're going to use single bass drum today. You can do it with double bass, no problem, but we're going to work out a single bass drum technique. The sticking for the hands is going to be right, left, just alternating sticking. So it's going to go right, left, foot, foot. I want to start the exercise on the snare drum. I always recommend this. That's what I call your comfort zone. It's where you spend the most time, kick, snare, and hi-hat. So we're going to start right there on the snare drum, very, very slow, playing groupings of four and two to make up the total of six notes. Spacing, very important. Make sure that the space between the bass drum is the same as the space between the snare drum. Now that you've got the muscle memory happening between the hands and the feet, let's try this with the click. So now, like I said before, we've got to fit these six notes evenly for every quarter note. Here it is, demonstrated at 60 beats per minute. As always, once that gets nice and settled, let's just simply practice moving the hands around the kit. You'll notice that in that exercise, when we're sort of getting used to moving around the kit, we'll just start off leaving one beat on each drum, four notes. Once that's comfortable, let's branch out a little more and let's just sort of let the hands go. Still keeping the four and two pattern, but not necessarily staying on one drum for the entire beat, just sort of moving around and checking out all the voicings on the kit. I recommend staying right here and practicing these exercises until they're really, really comfortable. Second nature, you're not thinking about it and you're locking really well with the click. Once that happens, it's time to move on and we're going to start to practice these in a one bar fill setting. Now, you'll notice that in this combination that we're working on, the last two notes are played on the bass drum. And for now, we're leaving that on a single bass drum, one kick drum. So the problem we're going to have is getting out of this. At slower tempos, it's no problem. You can play all three notes with your right foot. However, at faster tempos, we're going to have to do some adjusting here to get out of this fill. The first thing that you can do, obviously, is if you have a double pedal, you can switch to that and play those last notes right, left, right. That's almost another lesson in itself. I want to assume that you guys don't have double pedals and you're just on a single kick drum and the tempo's picked up a little bit and you want to do this type of fill. Well, a couple of ideas I'll share with you, things I've done. What you can simply do for that last beat, beat four, is just play all six notes with the hands. We'll be right back. Another technique I've used a lot, especially at faster tempos, is to simply stop the fill on beat four with a flam, and then I'll ad-lib some sort of a figure with the hands or the feet to sort of get through beat four and end up on one. Welcome to 16th Note Triplet Fills Part 1. This stuff's a lot of fun. You guys know the deal. Don't get overwhelmed. Slow this down. Muscle memory. Be very patient. We moved along kind of quick. We picked the tempo up and threw out some ideas, but you can always go back and revisit these ideas and always slow them down and grow at your own pace. We got a lot more to expand on this concept, so you guys check back and have fun.